And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We're about to enter, well, we're in Caed Nua. We're about to enter this structure here. There's another structure we can enter here. Big door, so I kind of passed that by for now. Looks like a major undertaking, so let's check this out. Brighthollow. Of course, this could be a major undertaking in itself.
No problem.
Just checking here. Sour odors of rancid grain and spoiled fruit permeate the air. Dust and rusted utensils cover the countertop. Nothing to be had in here, huh? Rats skitter among the broken stairs. Yeah, we can't go up those. Okay. Of course, you never know. This could... little structure could go down into this huge dungeon. You don't know sometimes. It seems to be only one way to go. Brighthollow. Oh, wow. The shelves creak under the books. Many of the covers are mottled with mildew. Nothing here? If we pass by things, we could find hidden items and such. But we're not finding anything. Cobwebs bind the remains of a broken alembic, a cracked mortar, and various shattered bottles and vials to the table. Seriously, that's it? There's nothing in here? There's no treasure, no monsters? It's pretty curious, I think. We'll look around a little bit more. Get closer to the walls and stuff, see if there's a hidden passage of some kind. A brick that can be moved or something. That's pretty... yeah, that's pretty odd, I think. Really, nothing else here? Huh. I guess just for atmosphere? And XP, I guess. Alright, let's continue our searching. Looking for this book. What's his name? Arcana wants a book. We can go all the way into this stuff. Didn't seem like a smart choice to do, but we did it. Before we go up, let's just go up there. What the hell? We got some Children of the Corn thing going on over here. Let me just look over here before I go up that path. Oh, we do keep going. Only weeds grow in this dusty patch. Let's just continue around this way for now. What is this? I can't go that way. Ah! Will-o'-the-wisp. Everyone get your bows out. Really enjoying this game, guys. Very awesome. Doesn't seem like we all get to go, does it? We might have, we might need to get better bows, you know, like quicker. You know what? Let's all just wail on this thing.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Yeah. So dramatic. Frayed lengths of rope and a few flint chips are scattered across this workbench. There's a little area back here. I can't see it, though. How do I get over there? I can't go back there, so... Okay, so we can't... Clear it out. I hate that. What's over here? We didn't get this stuff? This one we did.
Hmm.
Oh, we got it now. Can't go in there? Door's hanging open. Tangled wires and broken litter. Broken gears litter these wooden boxes? I think it said boxes. I can't look at it now. Ah! What's his name? Can level up. Let's do that next. Durance? Okay.
Hmm.
Cool. I love when that happens. Boxes, yes. All right. Let's go into the corn maze and then figure out what's in here.
Got it. And not be seen.
Oh, can't go in there? The hedges grow in shaggy heaps, shot through with weeds and tall grasses. But we can't go in there. Alright. Now, disappointing, you're leaving us with stuff we can't do anything with. Well, I guess we've defeated everything outside. There's a horn here.
And what does the flame reveal?
Find out. The old watcher. Enter the keep. Oh, I forgot about this. The spirit of Caldara directed us here. We'll find Meerwald. Meerwald is a watcher as well. Hmm. Oh, let's look at the bestiary. Flame Blight. Cool. These amorphous clouds rapidly swirl with violent energy. Within the maelstrom, dozens of humanoid shapes materialize and vanish within an instant. Faces scream in silent agony, while hands desperately clutch and claw at the air around the mass. Oh, like they're getting oxygen that way. Beowix, spirit winds, as these storms are known, often create blights. If souls are ripped free of bodies and caught in the center of the storm, they may become stuck together and bonded with other elemental substances in the maelstrom. They are pure chaos and confusion. Destroying them is considered a mercy to the souls trapped within. Experimenting with blight creation is yet another questionable activity that has earned animancers a bad reputation in many circles. Some see it as dangerous and inhumane, others as a means to an end. The creation of blights is an accusation many fearful kith level at animancers. Mm-hmm. They do, huh? I believe we've seen this. I'll let it sit here for a sec, in case you guys want to pause and read it. Other than that, we're done. Character statistics. Oh, it's just about the statistics, okay. But all that we can read about. Hold on.
Clearly of Adiran make. They like their archways.
So much for sneaking around, you're so freaking loud. Oh! Shadow. This guy isn't... whoever his name is in the middle of all this crap. We still have all our ranged weapons, so let's go.
Brave Dalsilad Fili.
I don't know if we can pass over that. We'll find out. Have him wait a second. Just a second, mind you. Amplified thrust over off of Eater and Holy Radiance, like normal. Oh, Aether's stunned for almost 2 seconds. One gone. Oh, there's another one coming to enter the fray here. Let's get rid of this phantom, shall we? Two phantoms? Oh boy. Where's our turn undead spell? Is she stuck on that side? It doesn't look like... I'm not sure if we can walk over that. Oh, it looks like we can. Alright, we got the cursor. Hmm. Well, this one's damaged. I don't want to attack this one. What did it say when I hit that? Oh, he's stunned. Wait. Phantom. Which ones? I thought they were damaged. I thought there was three bars. Damn it. I don't know. Doesn't look like... Oh, there's an effect there. Right? Blocking it. He really can't do anything. He's stunned. I guess I can't direct him right now, or I'll have to wait. Arcane Assault. There. Soul Shock off of Aether. Armor. Holy Armor? Whatever it's called. Armor of Faith. Oh boy. He's injured. Let's go with Restore Light Endurance. Another Arcane Assault here. I hope it doesn't hit our guys. Got another first level. What do you think? Minor endurance. We'll camp after this anyway. I don't think a necrotic. We could try this combusting thing.
We're Sunra.
Oh boy. Seems like they're hitting pretty freaking hard. What do we have left? We have the Phantom and the Shadow. Just wanna make sure we're all actually attacking here. He's out, so have him wait into battle. Unfortunately, Aloth's getting hit by this phantom. Kanna's almost out. Does he have anything? Field triage on himself. Oh boy, good. Good battle, huh? Okay, still want to check out this thing.
As you say.
Nice and quiet.
No traps or anything. Whispers of Yenwood, a unique sword one-handed. Eleven to 16 slash appears versus deflection, of course, reliable. 20% of grazes converted to hits. Plus 5 accuracy against spirit. Plus 25% damage against spirit. Minus 3 will. That's not good. Its blade, covered with graceful Glamfellen engravings, Whispers of Yenwood was once the sword of the first road warden of Caed Nua. When the Earl of Yenwood appointed Caed Eadhart, the young lord feared the spirits that were rumored to dwell under the young castle's foundation. He spent a sizable sum to have the black Emirin steel blade forged, shipped to the eastern reach for engraving by the Earl's Glamfellen slave artisans, and enchanted in New Dunreed. I'm saying that right. Caed is known to have used the sword in the Battle of Old Girin and to help the neighboring Radrics suppress an uprising in Gilded Vale, but there was no recorded use of it in Caed Nua. Over time, Caed began to believe that the sword had been cursed by the Glamfellen artisans who decorated it. He confided in those close to him that he thought the spirits of the dead were speaking to him through the blade while he slept. One evening, against the pleas of his wife and soldiers, a maddened Caed carried the sword deep into the misty woods of Ir Glamfath. His body was never recovered, but the next road warden the Earl assigned to Caed Nua found it waiting for him on the throne in the keep's great hall. None of the soldiers could explain how the sword had appeared there. No road warden had carried the sword since that day. I'm gonna have to think about that. I don't know who I want to, be missing this will. Okay. I hate actually. Doesn't make sense to just camp. You know what? Yeah. It doesn't make sense in for roleplay terms to camp without looking around, but if we look around, we're just going to get more fights, so. Oh, camping is not allowed in this area. Interesting. Huh. You wake to the sensation of being shaken, and you open your eyes to see Eder standing over you, his hand jostling your shoulder. He looks concerned. Your eyes are heavy and your vision blurred, the vague unease of unremembered nightmares clouding your thoughts. You are not sure you slept at all the previous night.
Hey. Hey! You're awake? Good. You were, kind of thrashing around, eyes rolled back in your head. Shaken. Trying to snap you out of it for a long time now. I was gonna have to get a bucket of cold water.
I would not have enjoyed that very much.
You don't seem like you get much rest at night. You got those dark circles under your eyes.
Not lately. At night there are dreams and whispers.
Well, it's the Watcher thing then. I'm sure it just takes some time to adjust is all. I'll try to let it sort itself out. Better wake up faster next time. Trust me, you don't want that bucket of cold water.
His smile is not one of a man convinced by his own words. Yeah, you pour water on me, I might slice you.
I shall be quiet as a cow.
Yeah, yeah. Cut that right off. See what else we can see before we have to call it an episode. And we can look at this table. The gray and brown pelts of mice flit between the boards. We can go up. Go in there. Oh, we can look at something over here, too. The brazier's chains are rigid with rust. That's not unexpected. There's a door here. Oh, locked, I suppose. Ooh. Steward, as you come to the end of the great hall, you perceive an inviting warmth radiating from a grand throne wrought out of marble, its masterful artistry out of place amidst the castle's more practical stonework. The veiled face of a woman is carved above the throne's backing, watching over the room with hollow eyes. As you approach, or at your approach, you feel the warmth fluctuate as though stirring. A voice rings out from the carving, permeating the fortress through stone and air. So we get this inviting, warm thing amidst all these evil things? Something's wrong there.
Another watcher in Caed Nua, glowing very brightly indeed to these eyes. What strange happenstance.
Who's that speaking?
I'm sorry if I startled you. I'm afraid my manners have been slipping. I haven't had much opportunity for introductions lately. In any case, I assume you're here looking for Meerwald.
Are you imprisoned in that throne?
Imprisoned? At times it feels that way, I suppose. But it's more that I reside here. The throne was brought up from the ruins. One of the first things they found. As a last favor to a dying woman, the Earl arranged for me to be moved into it. Audra is an accommodating vessel for a soul.
Really? So souls can inhabit these things. Well, that kind of makes sense. The title is Pillars of Eternity. So your soul can go into these, the Audra pillars for eternity?
Oh, it's not as confining as it seems. I can feel the whole keep from here, and all things that are tied to it. There's something about this throne and its construction. Or maybe it's something about this place.
Tell me more about Meerwald.
He was a great man. He came here one day, young with long hair and polished armor, and he banished the dark things that had come to lurk in this place after centuries of neglect. He could see the beauty of this place, the way it had been. So he claimed it for his own when no one else would take it. We worked together to restore it. But he began to grow distant some time ago. He never told me why. He retreated deeper and deeper into the keep, never leaving, sending servants for food, hiding himself from my sight. The restoration stopped. Now to look at the place. You'd never know the progress we'd made. In most places, it's worse than it ever was. And all I can do is watch it crumble around me.
That's pretty frickin' unfortunate. Any idea where I can find Meerwald?
I can feel his presence faintly somewhere deeper inside the keep. But he uses his gifts to confound me, and my senses are dulled while he does so. I only wish I could know his mind.
Why is he hiding from her? Confounding her and dulling her mind from his presence. Farewell.
Take care in your search. Many dangers lie in wait here.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt. Hello? door opens. The Watcher returns. Well, one of them at least. Have you had any luck finding Mirwald?
Take care in your search. Many dangers lie in wait here.
Excellent voice acting. Well, we can go here, or we can go here. That was locked. Now it's open. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time when we explore more of the Great Hall. Endure in enduring. Become strong. In enduring, grow strong.